Finally. So guys, welcome here. Welcome to Venice.
Thank you.
I told you before, I saw the movie and I loved it. That was pretty great to see, you know, James Franco behind the camera. And so James, congratulations. You did such a great work. And first
Thank
of all,
you.
Why you come up with this idea? What did you love about
Proctor, Salmoni? Well, Salmoni was an actor who was very big and successful in the 50s when he was a teenager. One of his first roles was in Rebel Without a Cause with James Dean, directed by Nicholas Ray, and he was nominated for an Oscar for that. He was then again nominated for another Oscar for Exodus, and, you know, was very popular, very successful. And then when he got into his 20s, for various reasons, you know, he kind of fell out of favor, which unfortunately is a tragedy that happens to a lot of performers, a lot of artists, a lot of musicians, a lot of, you know, creative types. And then he was murdered when he was 37 in 1976. And so I knew that there was something there that really fascinated me. I mean, one of the most basic things was that here I saw this very talented guy, and then when I would talk to people about him, a lot of people had kind of forgotten who he was or had forgotten his performances. And so for that reason alone, I thought, well, I'd love to make people aware of who he was. But even more than that, I wanted to tell a story about that kind of tragedy of a creative person who is unable to express all that he has inside, you know, and that kind of outlet had been cut off. And so that also affected the way we told the story. It wasn't, you know, a traditional biopic where you see Sal from a young boy up until his death. It's just one day in his life. And in that way, you get to just know the emotions of the character. So yes, it's about Sal, but it's also about all creative types that have so much that they can do and want to do and are just unable because of circumstances. You did a lot of preparation, huh? Months.
I did. When James told me that we're going to make this movie, I asked him, you know, what are we doing? And he said, we're going to make an unconventional movie about an unconventional man who lived an unconventional life. And he said, we're going to focus on the very last day of Sal Mineo's life. So, the first thing I did was learn as much as I can about him as a human being and him as an artist and all the amazing, extraordinary things that he accomplished in his life. Then we found out exactly what he did on that very last day of his life. And I worked backwards from there and tried to understand the choices that he had made and where he was at emotionally and mentally and as a human being and as an artist that led him to the position that he was in at the time that he passed. And once I got an understanding of that, my main focus was to try to pass that essence of him and that energy of him and that mentality and soul that he had at the time when he was 37 years old on the last day of his life. I kind of was hoping to pass that along to the audience, and that's how I approached it. It's a very intimate movie that James made and a very, very special, unique look at a human being that I myself have never, ever seen anything like that before in a movie, and much less been honored enough to be a part of it. So I figured the more intimately I can come to understand Sal, the more I can serve James and his vision and be able to express that to everybody watching. And that was the idea.
Well, I just went through film school. I just graduated from NYU Film School, and I certainly, you know, I have one or two teachers there that I really, you know, have been extremely influential and very helpful. So I certainly ran everything, you know, by them, and they, in every movie I do now, they give me, you know, feedback, and, you know, just kind of helps me, you know, formulate my thoughts and concepts and how we're going to proceed. And I would say, you know, my good friend Gus Van Sant has been a huge influence. But it doesn't really work. I don't really go out to, you know, I've worked with some of the best directors around, Danny Boyle and, you know, everyone, and Sam Raimi, and I don't really go to them and say, how would you do this? Because I find that I work better if I just kind of take the knowledge I've gained from working with them and then, you know, translate that into my kind of my own terms. And so in that way, you can just take the best or the most, you know, influential things from all of them and use them rather than, I don't know. I don't want them to direct the movie in a sense, I guess. I don't know, but it's just the way I work.
So actually, I was James Frank as a director. So now, sometimes movie critics and even the audience can be skeptical about affording an actor to the movie as a filmmaker as a director. But, I mean, Sean Penn, Menzel, was a great actor, he became one of the best directors ever. So how was James Franco as a director, not only the director chair, how was he?
Oh, I'd love to be true. I'd love to be true. For one, I think it's such a bad generalization to think that, you know, the idea of an actor being a director is a risky thing. I think it always depends on the individual. In this case, for this specific film, it was, I think, necessary. One of the things that was very helpful to me, it was a very fast shoot, and we had to tell a very intimate story in a very short amount of time. James set an atmosphere of relaxation that infected the entire crew, it infected me, it infected all of the actors, and out of that relaxed place, I think everyone did the best possible job that they could. So that was very, very important. Especially under the constraints where I think a lot of other people would have been cracking down, you know, for the amount of work that we had to do and the time that we had. So that was very special for me. Another of many things that he did was if he so much as saw either Christina Volos, the cinematographer, or myself off in a corner happening to be thinking about some idea, he would make a beeline for us and almost demand, what is it that you have on your mind? And what are you thinking? And not only was he open to our opinions, he focused on them and understood exactly what they are and made his decisions and was willing to experiment and work out of there. So he really respected the creativity of everyone on set. And that's why I think that everyone did their best work in such a short amount of time. That was really special. The idea that James, being an actor, and being an actor who I am personally a big fan of, is he knows how to talk to me, and he knew what not to say, and he knew how to speak to me in order to get me to behave, to express a certain kind of a mental place that the character was in. And that communication for an actor, I think, is absolutely priceless and can and literally direct a performance in one complete direction or another. That's just three of many ways, and I can go on, and that's true. Yeah, you're a sweet guy too, man.
No, I'm just a fan here, you know. And I love your work, and you want the best. I love your, guest appearance. You're important. So awesome, and the plan was spread and hilarious. So listen, Jim, actually, what do you expect from this movie? And are you thinking of shooting another movie as a filmmaker?
Yes, what do I expect? I think we can put it out. You know, it's obviously not like Planet of the Apes, you know, we're not going to put it out on thousands of screens. It's a very humble movie, but we made it that way on purpose. You know, we knew our subject and we wanted to make it in a very specific way, an unconventional way. So, but we also were very responsible with how we made it. So we don't need to, you know, put it out on thousands of screens. We can put it in, you know, specialty places, and the people that really want to see it and the people that, you know, appreciate this kind of movie will come and see it. And I think, you know, that's I think what will happen. As far as directing, yes, I have the rights to many, many books that I hope that I'm adapting, and so there'll be more movies soon. Yeah.
Right. What do you expect from this
movie? What do I expect from it? What I hope is that the audience can let go of the conventional idea of what it is to watch a film and to sit down and meditate with this film and appreciate Sal Mineo and appreciate getting to know someone in this way. Because like I said, I don't think it's ever been done before in this way that I've seen. What I expect from it is everything great, because that's what it deserves. It's the most special thing I've ever done, and I expect whoever watches it to feel the same way.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you, man.
And congratulations again.
All right.
Thank you. See you soon.